Hi guys, welcome to our channel Piping Mantra. Today we're going to look into a topic called pressure testing. So without wasting any further time, let's get to it. Pressure testing, either pneumatic or hydrostatic testing, is a procedure designed to test the strength and leaks in the piping system, boilers, gas cylinders, pressure vessels, etc., to confirm that they'll operate properly even under extreme conditions. Tests are also required after repairs and shutdowns to validate equipment, piping, and whether they can successfully return to operation. In the case of hydro testing, testing is conducted at higher pressures than normal operating pressures, typically up to 150% of the designed pressure. A pressure test or hydrostatic test is always required for a new pressure system before use or an existing pressure system after repair or alteration to ensure the following. Maintain safety standards, integrity of a vessel or pipeline system over time, leak and strength as per mechanical property as pipelines or vessels need to perform reliably and consistently in harsh environments. At times, pressure can reach extreme levels. Physical quality test in the fabrication process. Testing pressure vessels for the transport and storage of gases is very important because such containers can explode if they fail under pressure. To inspect the flange joints. To relieve the stresses from the system. Now let's talk about the types of pressure testing. In the process industry, two methods are widely used for pressure testing of piping or equipment. They are, the first is hydrostatic test or hydro test, and another one is the pneumatic test. Hydro test or hydrostatic tests involve filling the vessel or pipeline system with a liquid, usually water, which may be dyed to aid in visual leak detection. The vessel or piping is then pressurized to a specific test pressure and monitored for any pressure loss. The location of the leak can be visually identified more easily if the test liquid contains a colorant. In pneumatic test, air, nitrogen, or any other inert gas which is non-flammable and non-toxic is used as a test medium. Pneumatic tests are applied to systems where the hydrostatic test is difficult to apply. Pressure tests, both hydrostatic and pneumatic, must always be performed under controlled conditions following an approved test plan and documented in a test record. A single approved test plan could be used for several similar tests, but for each test, a separate test record is required. Now, let's come on to the preparation and requirements before hydro testing. For piping, a pre-test check shall be made to ensure that pipe support contact has been achieved at all support locations. This includes temporary supports provided only for hydro test. The temporary supports should be designed especially for large bore heavy piping to ensure they can sustain the hydrostatic loads. This verification may not be critical for small bore piping systems. Removal of temporary support should be done only after the test is complete and the lines are fully drained. All lines shall be checked to ensure the entire system can be completely drained after testing. Vents or other high point connections shall be opened to displace air from lines once the water filling starts during the hydrostatic test. All joints including structural attachments shall be left uninsulated or primed and exposed during hydrostatic testing. Some companies' procedures may allow exceptions to this requirement subject to certain conditions being met, such as extended test durations and the use of highly qualified welders. For equipment, all equipment that is to be excluded from the test shall be either disconnected from the system or positively isolated using spectacle blinds or blind flanges. Expansion joints and spring supports shall be provided with temporary restraints or stops to prevent excessive travel or deformation under the hydrostatic test loads. Inline valves should be in a fully open position during the hydrostatic leak test. Some companies recommend that ball valves should be in a partially open position as this allows the valve body cavity to be subjected to the pressure test. Orifice plates, spray nozzles and similar restrictions should normally be installed after the completion of the tests. When dismantling of piping is necessary to perform testing, less expensive gaskets suitable for the test pressure may be substituted. After completion of the test, the test gasket shall be replaced by the gaskets required as per piping specifications. Prefabricated spacers and spool pieces shall be fabricated and supplied to the correct test pressure rating by the contractor for replacing inline instrumentation during plant testing and flushing, except for equipment such as control valves with butt welding ends, which will be installed initially without internals and provided with a blind flange. Special attention shall be given to the provision of spacers and spool pieces required for the equipment packages. The default hydrotest fluid in most cases is water. Water used for hydrostatic testing of water shall be fresh, clean, and free from suspended solids and other foreign matter. Water may not be used as a hydrostatic test medium under the following circumstances. The presence of water in the piping system may have adverse effects during plant startup and operation. The piping material or its lining may deteriorate the presence of hydrotest fluid. There is a likelihood of test water being contaminated during testing and its disposal may pose environmental hazards. Drop in ambient temperature may cause water to freeze during the test. If the test fluid temperature produces condensation on the piping exterior surface, the water shall be heated to a temperature above the dew point or the test shall be delayed until such time that condensation will not occur on the external surface of the piping system under test. Water used for testing of stainless steel pipework shall not contain more than 30 ppm chlorides. Some owners permit up to 50 ppm chlorides and some owners impose a maximum limit of 15 ppm chlorides. This caution is exercised to avoid pitting and stress corrosion cracking in stainless steels. Water used for testing may be treated with chemical additives such as oxygen scavengers, biocide, and corrosion inhibitors. Hence, the disposal of test fluid shall be carried out per the local environmental regulations. Now let's talk about flushing. Before the hydro test, the system shall be flushed with the dedicated test medium to remove all dirt and foreign matter. Recommended methods for flushing are: for lines up to 6 inch diameter, liquid volume flushing. For this method, the minimum velocity in the largest pipe diameter is not less than 3 meters per second. For lines over 6 inch diameter, hydroblast using self-climbing high-pressure water jet nozzles called dynarod method or approved equivalent. For air, halon and hydraulic lines, air blast cleaning ensures a minimum velocity of 10 meters per second at the outlet end is achieved. All necessary precautions shall be taken to avoid debris being pushed into associated equipment or dead ends. Flushing shall proceed in an intermittent manner, allowing time between flushes for debris to be cleared from the line. Flushing shall continue for sufficient time to ensure that line is cleaned to the satisfaction of the company. Let's talk about the main equipment used for pressure tests. That is, pressure test manifold. A pressure test manifold is used for performing a hydro test. The pressure test manifold has the required provisions to test and protect the piping system subjected to hydro test and comprises of the following. Manifold provided with end cap suitable for system pressure testing. It is recommended that all joints in the test manifold are of a welded type and should be subjected to 100% non-destructive examination by MPI and radiography. Pressure relief valve of adequate capacity to relieve the system of any overpressure. A manual bleed valve for emergency bleeding and depressurization of the piping system if the relief valve fails. A pressure gauge, pressure recorder, and temperature recorder connection. The pressure gauge should be calibrated preferably within 4 weeks of the test being carried out. The hydro test pressure should preferably fall within 35 to 75% of the full range of the pressure gauge. A connection to connect the hydro test or pneumatic pump to the manifold. A connection to connect the test manifold to the low point of the piping system for filling and pressurization. Hoses that connect the pump to the test manifold and the test manifold to the piping system shall be rated for the test pressure and fitted with safety chains of sufficient strength that will prevent whipping of the hose should the coupling get disconnected. All valves and fittings on the manifold shall be of the next higher rating. The strength of the test manifold should be validated by testing the manifold between 1.2 to 1.4 times of its rated system test pressure. Note that the ASME B31.3 code does not provide any guidance on the recommended test pressure. These are based on construction industry practices. Now let's look at the requirements during the pressure test. During the pressure test, the pressure shall be gradually increased to allow time for the material to equalize the strains. After the piping subject attains the required test pressure, it is recommended to stay clear from the test area for a period of 10 minutes before examining the joints and connections for leaks. As per Para 345.2.2 of ASMVB 31.3, a hydrostatic leak test shall be maintained for at least 10 minutes and all joints and connections shall be examined for leaks. Many company specifications prescribe a minimum hold time of 30 minutes to detect small seepage leaks and to permit a thorough inspection of joints and connections. For internally coated piping such as FBE coated piping system, it should be ensured that the coating is not damaged when the subject to the full test pressure. When the test has to be maintained for some time during which thermal expansion of the test medium might occur due to the changes in the ambient temperature, the contractor should ensure that the test system is not subjected to a pressure greater than the specified test pressure. A flange joint at which the spectacle blind or blank is inserted to isolate other equipment during the test need not be examined for leaks. These joints should be subject to a flange management procedure and leak tested during initial service. Now let's move on to the important points to consider during hydrotest. Orifice plates, spray nozzles and similar flow restriction instruments or components should be installed after completion of the hydrotest. If it is required to dismantle the piping system to perform testing, use the less expensive gasket. After completion of the test gasket shall be replaced with gasket specified in the PMS, that is, piping material specification. Fill the line slowly. This will enhance the probability of removing all air from the line. The testing pump should be connected at the lowest point of the line. Priming of the pump is required to remove all the air present in it. The pump should be isolated from the line to prevent backflow. Now let's have a look on requirements after the pressure test. All piping should be completely drained of all test fluid. Special attention may be required to ensure the draining of pockets where the test fluid is likely to be trapped. While draining the system, due care should be exercised to open one of the vent walls to ensure that the piping system is not subjected to vacuum and subsequent collapse. All piping tested with water in which the presence of water is detrimental to the process startup and operation should be thoroughly dried. The piping shall be blown down with air to ensure that there are no trapped water pockets and the piping is dry. Now let's have a look on the sensitive leak test, where the owner considers both hydrostatic and pneumatic leak testing is impracticable. The alternative specified in Para 345.9 of ASMAB 31.3, which requires the system to be subjected to a sensitive leak test, may be used if both of the following conditions apply. A hydrostatic test would damage linings or internal insulation or contaminate a process which would be hazardous, corrosive or inoperative in the presence of moisture or would present the danger of brittle fracture due to low metal temperature during the test. A pneumatic test would present an undue hazard of the possible release of energy stored in the system or would present the danger of brittle fracture due to low metal temperature during the test. The test pressure shall be at least the lesser of 1 bar, that is 100 kilopascal, or 25% of the design pressure. If a sensitive leak test is required, joints will also be left unprimed and unpainted. Let's discuss the waiver of hydrostatic test. Waiver of hydrostatic test organizations requires approval of the owner's integrity assurance department. A waiver of hydro test may be given due consideration by the integrity department if it can be proven that the contractor has exhausted all possible options available to perform testing of the piping system. Now let's refer to the difficulties with the hydrostatic testing. There could be difficulties in supply and disposal of water, disposal of fluid additives. A water leak can cause equipment damage, freezing, limitations of the structural support, contamination into process fluid, may damage internal refractory linings. When it comes to pneumatic testing, the pneumatic tests are potentially more dangerous than the hydrostatic tests because of the higher level of potential energy stored during the compressing of the gas. Must be exercised to minimize the chance of brittle failure during testing by initially assuring the system is suitable for pneumatic testing. Needs the involvement of senior experienced staff to monitor the test. Some equipment shall be excluded from all piping pressure tests. Vessels and tanks, heat exchangers, rotating machineries such as pumps, compressors and turbines, equipment and supplier furnished piping specifically recommended by the manufacturer not to be tested. Underground portions of piping systems may be tested and covered before testing above ground portions. Now look at the pressure test requirements as per different standards, such as ASME B31.1. For hydrostatic pressure, the pressure has to be 1.5 times the design pressure, and for pneumatic testing, the pressure has to be 1.2 times the design pressure. For ASME B31.3, for hydrostatic test, the pressure should be 1.5 times the design pressure. For the pneumatic test, the pressure should be 1.1 times the design pressure. Similarly, for ASME B31.9, the hydrostatic pressure should be 1.5 times design pressure, and pneumatic test pressure should be 1.25 times design pressure. In case of ASME section 1, the hydrostatic pressure should be 1.5 times of MAWP, where MAWP is the maximum pressure that the weakest component of the piping system can handle. And in case of ASME section 1, the pneumatic testing is not permitted. For NFPA 13 fire system, the hydrostatic pressure is 200 psi and the pneumatic testing pressure is 40 psi. Now, let's refer to the pressure test formula. PT is equal to 1.5 into P into ST by S, where PT is the minimum hydro test pressure, P is the internal design pressure, ST is the allowable stress at test temperature, and S is the allowable stress at the design temperature. Note that the ratio of ST by S should not exceed 6.5. For getting the value of S and ST, see table A1, appendix A, ASME B31.3. For water volume calculation, the formula is V is equals to 0.0408 into D square into L, where V is the gallons required to fill at 0 PSIG, L is the length of the test section in feet, D is the diameter of pipe in inches. So that is it, guys, for today's video. We love reading your comment and suggestions, so please comment below. We do read every single one of your comment. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share with your friends and colleagues who may find it useful. If you have any time, please check out our other videos over there.